I didn't understand that shit at first. I'm glad I watched it again. That's the protruding bottom that he was talking about, right there. Oh my goodness. What a clarity. This is so clear, damn. And there is another one down there. So there's two of them. And there is another one on the floor, on the ground. And that's Uranus. So, and I see like a saucer shaped thing down there. So really, the round thing is another vehicle, not a rock. And the tubular thing that says number two and number one, that's the big cylindrical thing with the holes that shoots the stuff that makes the ring. Oh my God, I understand now the picture. Wow, and they can change shape. It can be round or cylindrical or big or small as they want to. Damn. And what is that on there? A creature? Sort of look like something weird. Now I understand the picture.
My original thought was that this object right here was a part of a continuous object that goes through here. Actually, what it looks like, the object is here and goes way down through here. So I have to change my mind about the way this picture looks. But nevertheless, this looks like a short EMB right through here. And there's a streamer that rises right up there. And then there's, this would be the end. You can see it's sort of circular in character. And it has a protrusion down below it. And that is characteristic of the kind of thing that I saw at Pahara Dunes. And then there is projection material out here. And that too is characteristic of one of these EMVs. Now it looks like that in fact there are, in the way they got them blown up here, that there is another object right in here, and that it has a lateral protrusion way out here, and there is emission from it. The thing that I think is so significant about this picture is that these elements right down here at the bottom, they're thin little things, labeled 8 and 9, I call them energy rolls because obviously these EMVs can
change shape,
use something, and they carry along with them so that they can make any kind of form that they want. And so to me, these elements along here stores, such as like a fire airplane carries torpedoes and so forth, they call that stores. And now, with those in position there, you see they've controlled all of the emissions that have come out of that area. They've done it deliberately, and underneath there, why, they probably have something that we'd like to know about. So, it it shows that they're capable of managing their image look. Now that they're electromagnetic, that means that they can do this to make any shape they want, an infinite number of shapes. And so what you find is that in being an infinite number of shapes, you can't, you think you're seeing things that are different from time to time. Well, in a way that's true, but it's all coming from one kind of unit, and it just has varying things that it can do. And so these varying things can look different, so that you lose the significant idea that there is one basic thing that's showing all these
peculiar things.
Change
all kinds of form and shapes and sizes. That's incredible.
Now, how are ringmakers as UFOs? Well, the answer to that question is they make darn good UFOs. At the top of the picture to the left, now first let me say the little black bar wherever it appears is just a simple representation of an EMV. Now, on the top to the left, why, it shows a hump on the top and the bottom. To the right of that, why, that hump and what's around there, it could make it look like a hat. And the central picture would be a cross-section of that, and it would look that way. Now, they can have emissions that are not circular. They can shape them so it looks like that. But they also can make any number of different appearances, so it could be square for that matter. Now, you go down to the lower left corner, and you see an L-shaped object. You have an EMV projecting only to the right, and so you have an L shape. And as a matter of fact, I've seen an account of an L shape, but that's how you do it.
I found them everywhere.
You could have the projection on the other side.
So you want a U shape.
Okay, and so on the right lower hand corner, you have a lenticular cloud like formation, and you have the EMV in it. That's a typical kind of thing that they can pull. And you see a lenticular cloud, quite possibly there's an EMV in there. So you can see that they have qualities that make them candidates for making UFOs. But we've got to get into the mode of IFOs, where we identify things, and this begins to bring things to closure and understanding. So the EMV is a long cylindrical object now. It's electromagnetic in character, and we should be referring that as an IFO. Now they have stuff that they give off, and we should begin now to label the stuff they give off. And we only know if we can find the EMV at the time and begin to piece all this stuff together. It'd be a fascinating thing to find all the capabilities.
Oh my God.
Here is a cover that of a report that was put out by the UNESCO under the auspices of the National of Da Vinci in Rome. The reason why I show that is that I was at Rome where they put on a congress and they wanted to have something on the nature of impact of science on culture. And that's the charter of UNESCO. So I chose the